Our planet is blessed with a vast variety of exotic animals. While the sea is filled with our planet's largest creatures, on land, some mammals also grow to incredible sizes and amass so much weight. Among these are the elephant being the largest, and then the rhinoceros coming in second place. Being the two largest land animals, it is not uncommon to find these two sometimes at loggerheads. Another common sight is seeing a rhino versus a hippo or a group of buffaloes fighting over water holes. A rhino is so massive to the extent that it can attack and easily flip a car and its occupants. By the way, do you know that hippos cause more human deaths per year than rhinos? You would be shocked at the wide margin, but that is a discussion for another section of this video. The rhinoceros has a distinctive physical characteristic from which it derives its name. Having its origin in Latin and Greek, the name literally means nose horn. Massive and intimidating, the rhino has a large head with one or two horns depending on the species. Supported by four short legs, it has a thick hairless skin, which is like body armor in areas such as its shoulders and thighs. While this barrel-shaped beast looks like ancient creatures such as the extinct Triceratops dinosaur, surprisingly, its closest living relative, however, are horses and tapirs. There are five species of rhinos, all of which are categorized based on skin color and where they may be found. We'll talk more about that later in this video. For now, let's examine just how massive these gigantic horned mammals can get. Of the five species of rhinos, the Sumatran rhino is the smallest, as it would often measure 5 feet or 1.5 meters tall at shoulder level and 8 feet or 2.4 meters in length. The largest species, however, is the white rhino, which could grow to lengths measuring 13 feet, 4 meters, and stand as tall as 6.5 feet or 2 meters at the shoulder level. In terms of weight, the rhinoceros equally packs a robust weight that is commensurate with its lumbering large appearance. A fully grown rhino weighs between 3 and 4 tons. That is, indeed, a respectable weight to carry around on those short, sturdy legs. Before we consider habitats and locations where rhinoceros can be found, there is the need to fulfill the earlier promise of naming all five species of rhinoceros. These are the white rhino, which is also known as the square-lipped rhino, the black rhino, which is also known as hook-lipped rhino, the Indian rhino, also known as greater one-horned rhino, Javan rhino, and Sumatran rhino. These five species can be found on only two continents of the world, Africa and Asia. The black and white rhino are also sometimes called African rhinos, as they are predominantly found in the African continent in countries such as Ethiopia, Angola, Sudan, Zimbabwe, Botswana, Namibia, Zambia, Kenya, Uganda, and South Africa, where the largest population of all rhino species can be found. The greater one-horned rhino, also known as the Indian rhino, is native to India and Nepal, while the Javan and Sumatran rhino are both found in Indonesia and Malaysia. In these various countries and continents, the rhinoceros prefer floodplains, grasslands, rainforests, and swamps or marshes. Interestingly, Europe also has a certain kind of woolly rhino, which became extinct during the Pleistocene. It's no mistake that rhinos look like triceratops, even though they are not related. This is because rhinos are ancient creatures that have been on Earth for the last 14 million years. Generally, rhinos have a lifespan of 35 to 50 years. Over the course of their half-century lifespan, rhinos would eat a variety of things. Rhinos eat leaves, fruits, browse trees, graze grasses, shrubs, plant shoots, vegetables, bark, roots, and many more. Of these, they consume about 110 pounds or 50 kilograms of food on a daily basis. They would spend hours either grazing on grasses or browsing the leaves of trees. Another crucial element which the rhino require is water. A rhino may walk up to 10 miles or 16 kilometers from where it grazes to a watering hole, especially when there is a drought or during the African dry season. You certainly would agree with me that it is not easy being a rhino. Imagine having to carry that huge bulk from over 10 miles or 16 kilometers distance just to eat or drink. They graze or browse for food at dawn and dusk. Since their skin is very sensitive and may be sunburned easily, rhinos would often spend hours wallowing in the mud in order to protect their skin against bites and also serves as a sunscreen. Despite their huge mass, rhinos are extremely agile. They can charge at a person or animal with speeds up to 60 kilometers per hour, about 37 miles per hour. And if they miss, they can always turn around very quickly for a second attempt. You may have noticed that rhinos may sometimes charge at emptiness or for no reason. The reason for this is that their eyesight is so poor to the point that if a person were to stand motionless at just about 30 meters or 100 feet away, a rhino wouldn't see the person. However, they possess excellent sense of smell and hearing. Hence, they may sometimes perceive sound or smell and then charge without even knowing where exactly the sound or smell is coming from. Do they have predators? When you get that big and have such a natural body armor, there is practically no predator that would dare consider you suitable for lunch. As a result, adult rhinos have no natural predators, except humans, of course. Rhinos are often poached for their skin, and more especially their horn. In the Asian continent in particular, these horns are high-value commodities, and they are often deployed as decorative ornaments as well as being a component of traditional medicine. Poachers consider these horns immensely valuable to the extent that, in the last 5 years alone, about 500 poachers have been shot dead in South Africa's Kruger's National Park. But this nonetheless does not deter some poachers who seek the slightest opportunity to cut the horns of rhinos using a chainsaw. As a result of heavy poaching and human activities, three species of rhinos are critically endangered. Only the black rhino's population has improved considerably. Young rhinos, however, are sometimes attacked by animals like crocodiles, big cats, and hyenas. Against popular belief, rhinos are actually gentle giants. If you find it hard to believe, let's examine this fact statistically and by comparison. Did you know that while rhinos fatally injure only 2 to 3 humans each year, elephants are responsible for as many as 400 to 500 fatalities annually? The same goes for the hippo, which causes the death of about 500 people annually as well. Even though rhinos do indeed attack and sometimes flip cars, the attacks almost never end fatally. Now, compare the statistics of a rhino versus that of a hippo. While rhinos are said to be gentle giants, this does not, however, rule out the possibility of aggression. The African black rhino is particularly the most aggressive of all five species. Female rhinos with calves would often tend to show aggression, which is a natural instinct to protect their young. Whatever we do, it wouldn't be wise going close to a rhino, as they can easily crush you. Human activities have greatly reduced the distribution and thriving populations of these elephantine creatures. Only 5 species are left, being the second largest terrestrial animal and comparatively peaceful and easygoing. It would be sad to see these ancient creatures go into extinction. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and comment below.